everyone, thanks for tuning in. Today I'm going to continue my series of tutorials on Logic plugins, and today's plugin is the single band EQ. If that all sounds good, make sure you like and subscribe and hit the notification bell, all that stuff, and I'm going to get started. To get to the single band EQ, click here, go down to Logic, go to EQ, go to single band EQ, click stereo. You're there. That's half of it. Single band EQ is simply a one band EQ plugin. My previous video was on Logic's channel EQ, and if you missed that, there's a link to it somewhere up there. I'll also have it linked down in the description. This is basically just one band from that channel EQ plugin, and it can be anything you want, but only one. So one cut or boost, basically. I'll pull up the regular EQ as a comparison. So low cut, this right here is basically this, okay? Your low cut, high pass. Low shelf is this right here. Parametric are any of these four middle ones, basically a bell. And then you have high shelf, which is this right here, and high cut, which is this right here. So those are your five options within the single band EQ plugin. Other than that, you've got the same three options that are down here in the channel EQ. So on this high cut, you have frequency, slope, and Q factor. On the shelves, you have frequency gain and Q factor, and same thing on the parametric, frequency gain and Q factor. That's it. So a good practical application for this is, say you've got like some drum close mics and they all just have some mud. You can pull that out with a parametric EQ. So we'll pretend that this drum kit I'm about to play is a single mic, and we'll find some room mud and pull that out. Like right there. Pull all that out. That's one way you could use it. The other thing I would recommend using this for is just a simple low cut. You might not always need a whole channel EQ, but you definitely would want to roll off some low frequencies. So you can definitely use this for that. Just roll it up, get rid of lows, that simple. Or if you want to simply add some lows, you can do that too. Add some highs. Take out some highs. Cut some highs. If you're doing any sort of electronic music, this is a great way to automate filter sweeps, because it's just like one knob right there. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying. Another way I would use this is as a low cut when my primary EQ does not have a low cut. So right here, I like to use the API style EQs a lot because they're steppable and really easy to use, but they don't have a roll off. I mean, they do. They have this filter right here, but it doesn't always roll off what I want it to. So let me play. That's not taking like what I would want out of the low end out. So that's where something like this would come in handy, is you can toggle this and actually remove the low end you want. And then you free up your actual EQ plugin to be any sort of color thing you want, regardless of if it has that low cut. Small things like that are perfect for the single band EQ. You could also use it as, say you get all the way to the end of your channel strip, you've got a lot of plugins you've already EQ'd, and like you just need like a little something. Single band EQ would be perfect for that. I knew this was going to be a quick video, and we're already done. So if that was helpful, if you enjoyed that, let me know down in the comments. If you have any questions about the single band EQ, feel free to let me know down there as well. Make sure you like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.